Please be seated. Inga mana, inga reo, inga ho e fa. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Pro-Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, University staff, special guests, graduands, whānau and supporters. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of the council members and staff of the university. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland at which the Pro-Chancellor and I will confer diplomas and award degrees in the Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences and the Faculty of Science. Graduation is a time for celebrating success. Today, you will experience the pomp and tradition of this ancient ceremony and the recognition befitting your success on your well-deserved day of celebration. Like your family and friends gathered here, we are very proud of all your achievements and look forward to your lifelong involvement as members of the University of Auckland family. Of course, graduation represents more than just a day of celebration. Your qualification from this university will have a lifetime impact on you, your family, and the community at large. We know that, compared to those whose formal education ends in high school, graduates have lower unemployment rates, higher salaries, better career prospects, and better health outcomes. Universities New Zealand has estimated that the lifetime benefits of earning a degree are valued between $1 million and $4 million. Your university experience and the qualifications gained at university will thus add real value to your lives and the lives of those around you. The fact that our university can add value in these ways reflects the abilities and achievements of our staff and students. In the Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences, we've seen several notable achievements in the last year. Distinguished Professor Ian Reid won the top honour from the Royal Society of New Zealand, the Rutherford Medal, for his research into metabolic bone diseases such as osteoporosis and Paget's disease. He was also awarded the Health Research Council of New Zealand Lilly Medal, and together with colleagues Associate Professors Mark Boland and Andrew Gray, won the 2015 Prime Minister's Science Prize. Dr. Alana Curtis won a National Tertiary Teaching Excellence Award in the Kaupapa Māori category. Professor Keith Petrie won the Mason Dury Medal for his research into patients' perceptions of illness and their impact on recovery and coping. Professor Ed Mitchell was awarded the Health Research Council's Bevan Medal for his research into preventing sudden infant death syndrome, also known as cot death. Professor Edward Gain was elected a Fellow of the Royal Society of New Zealand. In the Liggins Institute, Professor Sir Peter Gluckman received the insignia of the Order of New Zealand for his services to science. Amita Bansal, a PhD student, received the US Endocrine Society's award for the top publication in endocrinology by a trainee in 2015. And Dr. Claire Reynolds was awarded the Sir Charles Hircus Research Fellowship by the Health Research Council. Similarly, in the Faculty of Science, Dr. Alex Taylor won the MacDiarmid Emerging Scientist Prize at the 2015 Prime Minister's Science Prize Awards for his research into the evolution of intelligence. Associate Professor Stephanie Cohen was awarded the Research Medal by the New Zealand Association of Scientists for his discoveries in miniature optics. Marie McEntee won a Sustained Excellence in Teaching Award in the National Tertiary Teaching Excellence Awards. Distinguished Professor Margaret Brimble was named one of the year's Distinguished Women in Chemistry or Chemical Engineering by the International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. And Professors Alexei Drummond and Thomas Lumley and Associate Professor Janet Wilmshurst were elected Fellows of the Royal Society of New Zealand. This is an impressive list of achievements. To ensure that we can continue to achieve successes like these and to enhance our contribution to future generations of graduates and to our nation, I believe the university must do three things. First, we need to attract students of high academic potential and give them an outstanding academic and extracurricular experience. In this respect, I believe we're doing very well. The proportion of domestic students entering the university with a high grade point average is growing each year, and we produce outstanding graduates just like you. Second, we need to attract, develop, and retain outstanding staff. This we are doing, as illustrated by the achievements I've just described. Many of our staff are world leaders in their fields, and you will have been privileged to learn from and work with them. It's no coincidence, therefore, that in the QS World Rankings of University Subjects, the University of Auckland came top in New Zealand in 35 of the 40 ranked subjects, and we don't even teach two of them. So if we just say that again, a different way, there are 40 ranked subjects, we teach 38 of them, and we're ranked top in 35 of them. To me, it sounds like an impressive result. And third, we need to create the kind of academic environment and facilities that support and encourage excellence. To this end, the university has been investing heavily in its campus renewal program so as to ensure that we do provide facilities of genuine international quality. Many of you will graduate today with a first qualification, and you will be rightly proud of this achievement. However, I also want you to reflect on the ongoing learning opportunities and the wide range of postgraduate options available to you at this university. You must never rest on your laurels in a challenging and ever-changing world, but rather be prepared to embrace change and new technology and make the most of the opportunities presented to you. Although it may seem a daunting prospect right now, further study and learning is inevitable for us all as the world changes around us at an ever-accelerating pace. So whatever path you follow, I urge you, as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university, to never forget your alma mater, your university. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. But today is your day, with the focus firmly on your achievement. At this ceremony, we honour your success, along with the support of your family, whānau, and the others who have sustained you through these studies. I congratulate you, and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. I am pleased to introduce to you our guest speaker, Matt Bostwick, who has a master's degree in political studies and a graduate diploma in business, both from the University of Auckland. Matt works for Microsoft, where he supports New Zealand tech companies through global marketing partnerships, app development support, and joint product innovation. Previously, he managed Microsoft's relationship with universities and polytechnics. Prior to joining Microsoft, Matt worked at Alcatel-Lucent, where he held a number of sales and marketing roles in the energy and media sectors, both here and in Australia. He also led Alcatel-Lucent's early involvement in the ultra-fast broadband rollout. He's worked in marketing roles at both Cordia and Spark. Matt started his career as an assistant to Mayor Bob Harvey at Waitakere City Council, where he developed an interest in sustainable urban development. Matt has a passion for innovation, ideas, and helping New Zealanders excel on the world stage, especially in the areas of science and technology. In his spare time, he likes to mentor early stage tech startups and play football and do science experiments with his children. Please join with me in welcoming Matt.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of council, members of the university, graduands, families, whānau and friends. Kia ora koutou, greetings to you all. Now first let me apologise, I know you'd much rather be hearing from someone from Microsoft who's really interesting and inspirational like maybe Bill Gates, and instead you got me. I'll do my best. I'm incredibly honoured to be here today to be part of this great occasion and to celebrate your achievements. I congratulate you all on what you've accomplished. And I'd like to start by sharing a story with you. 21 years ago, actually almost to the day, I was in the final year of my arts degree and working a part-time job to cover the rent and pay for my regular visits to Shadows, which I'm sure many of you will understand. The job I had was a kind of general dog's body gig at a local film editing studio in Grafton. And basically I got paid minimum wage to file old video cassettes. You'll need to look that up if you don't know what a video cassette is. Pick up lunch for the film company clients, run a few errands and sweep the floors. Now to be honest, for someone doing a BA, I was perfectly qualified for this job. But on this particular afternoon in May 1995, I remember that a bunch of clients had just left and I was there on my own pushing a broom around. Someone had left the telly on and I was watching probably the most amazing spectacle I'd ever seen on TV. Not The Bachelor, no. It was the live broadcast of Peter Blake and the rest of the crew of Black Magic on their Queen Street Victory Parade. Some of you may remember this. The Team New Zealand crew had just won the America's Cup for New Zealand for the very first time. And watching the scenes on the TV, I felt like the whole of Auckland was there cheering them on. Hundreds of thousands of people were lining Queen Street, hanging off lampposts, sitting on the top of bus stops. People were leaning out of the windows of every building, and the whole place was covered in paper streamers and confetti. Everyone was cheering and screaming and waving flags. Quite similar to your procession this morning, I'm sure. Anyway, I remember Peter Blake being interviewed on the back of a ute as it drove slowly through the sea of people. You could hardly hear him over the noise of the crowd, but you could hear the utter disbelief in his voice as he looked around and said, "I've never seen anything like this before." And he was absolutely right. No one had ever seen anything like it. There were 300,000 people there on Queen Street that day, 300,000 people who were so inspired by what Team New Zealand had achieved that they'd come out to celebrate. And they'd celebrated with the biggest street parade we'd ever seen. Now, watching that parade, I realised that when it comes to acknowledging achievement, New Zealanders really know how to celebrate, as long as that achievement involves some kind of sporting endeavour. Now, recently, as I've thought again about that day in 1995 and about being here today with you, a thought struck me. Wouldn't it be amazing if, as a country, we celebrated achievements in science as much as we celebrate achievements in sport? And of course, the great irony of what actually enabled New Zealand to win the America's Cup was incredible scientific achievement. The advances in hydrodynamics and boat design that enabled the team to build a faster boat. The data analytics that allowed the team to analyse the performance of every piece of equipment on the boat and find ways to make the boat go faster. And even the sports science that enabled the team to find better ways to train, condition, and prepare the crew. So maybe those 300,000 people who crowded onto Queen Street that day, 21 years ago, were in fact inspired by the scientific achievements of Team New Zealand. At least I like to think so. But that's why I'm so glad to be here today as part of this celebration, because today is an opportunity to celebrate science and to celebrate you, to celebrate your achievements today, and to celebrate where you'll go and what you'll achieve in the future. So as you think about your future and embark on the next exciting phase of your life journey, let me share a couple of quick thoughts that I hope will be relevant. The first is that you should be immensely proud to be science and health science grads. As Mark Largent, who's a science historian and a professor at Michigan State University, says, you are it. He says, you possess the wheel of the largest and most powerful institution that ever existed, modern science. And I reckon as science and health science grads, you've got some really important things going for you. Nelson Mandela once said, education is the most powerful weapon with which you can change the world. And as scientists, you are in an incredible position to use your knowledge and skills and your education to change the world and contribute to things that really matter. So use your skills to change the world and make sure that whatever you do, do something you're passionate about. For many people, work is something they have to do to make ends meet. But if the work you do is something you care about, something with meaning that you love doing, you're incredibly lucky, because then work won't feel like work. And on an individual level, you're also in a great position to have really rewarding careers over the course of your working lives. As scientists, you're also well placed to take advantage of what the Chancellor just referred to, that changing nature of work and the increasing demand for graduates with skills in science and tech. The Future of Jobs report, which the World Economic Forum published earlier this year, found that globally, businesses are really struggling with recruitment, and that's because there just aren't enough graduates with the right set of skills out there. And they say that shortage is going to last for at least the next 5 years. So be confident that your skills and your passion will help you get a great job and have a great career. But once you've got that first job, don't think you're done. Just because you've graduated and got a job doesn't mean you can stop learning. Think about this. Today's graduate will have, give or take, a working life of 45 years. So you'll most likely finish up your career in a job that doesn't even exist today. The only constant is change. So embrace change, stay across new developments and technology, and commit to being a lifelong learner. The writer William S. Burroughs said it best when he said, "The aim of education is the knowledge, not of facts, but of values." The most important thing you can take away from your time at university is not the content you've learnt, but the art of learning itself. So take me as an example. I did an arts degree. I studied politics, philosophy, and art history, but I've ended up working for a global software company helping New Zealand tech startups grow their businesses. And although I spent days sweating over art history essays, I can tell you now that no one at Microsoft has ever asked me why Picasso used collage as an art form. But all of those late nights studying for exams about Picasso and Renaissance painting weren't a waste of time. The skills I learned at university have served me well in my career. Skills like adaptability and how to work with others and the ability to communicate effectively. So in case you were wondering, the World Economic Forum says the top three skills that employers will be looking for in 2020 will be complex problem-solving skills, critical thinking skills, and creativity. So let me finish by saying this. Congratulations, you've made it to the start line. And now you know how to learn, make sure you never stop learning. And if you want to have a great job in 2020, use your knowledge of science to solve complex problems, think critically, and be creative. Thank you, and enjoy your day.
Thank you, Matt, for that insightful and challenging address. Would you please join with me in thanking Matt once again? The This is a meeting of Council and Convocation of the University, at which the Pro-Chancellor, Scott St John, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of the ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Scott St John, Pro-Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who within the Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences and the Faculty of Science have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences, Professor Fraser, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences. To the degree of Bachelor of Pharmacy with First Class Honours, Helen Gwyneth Brown. Senior Scholar, Medical and Health Sciences, Robert James Hauer. To the degree of Bachelor of Pharmacy with Second Class Honours First Division, Murad Al Gailani. Laura Frances Baker. Francois Baribol. Claire Louise Bell. Ming Chiong Choi. Patricia Chong. Gina Patrice Egger. Monica Maheb Hallam Geris. Gina Gwindi. Tae Kyung Han. Laura Lee Harris. Neha Nalima Lau. Jinal Laxmidas. Catherine Ruth Moritz. Wen Fang Si. Lucy Sheed. Courtney Skinner. Nancy Sue. Peter Andrew Tizard. Gulen Kaur Wadwa. To the degree of Bachelor of Pharmacy with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Anita Anoja Ubagunasekara. Nicola Lotus Augustine. Yuna Bai. Brent Hal Brownbridge. Nathaniel Thomas Buckley. Andy Chan. Li Sha Chen. Joyce Chow. Zi Nun Hu. Jay Yi Deng. Emma Lynn Jeffrey. Dashia Jayendranath. Janelle Marie Jaram. Won Young Kim. Himisha Kumar. Selena Lee. Seulji Lim. Xiao Wei Lin. Marisa Annalise Lockhart. Samuel Y. Kwong Lum. Ashley Ma. Shabnam Mahboob. Corbin James O'Neill. Divya Patel. Neelam Bharat Patel. Sarah Francis Puri. Reddy Ramakrishna. Zaid Abul Rahman Abul Munan Rashid. Pooja Kavita Rathod. Yasmin Ayad Razoki. Nafisa Riyumi. Annie Piaporn Sangaruthong. Tara Obai Ziki Solji. Ziki Wang. Sevilla Wijaya. Bo Yan Wong. Seung J. Yo. Betty Becky Zam. Simon Zhu. To the degree of Bachelor of Pharmacy, Reham Farooq Abdallah. Seo Young Ahn. Maroa Al Hakim. Ala Ali Jawad Al Khalifa. Jolyn Claudette Alfonso. Hamza Al Rikabi. Tamur Makram Binam. Rashida Pui Man Fok. Shalini Kathiswaran. Hyun Jung Kim. Amina Motawaze. Jerome Gakuzan Pakwin. Rafi Basil Akram Rassam. Bharathi Ravichelvan. Daniel Shin. Pom Shik So. Suzanne Tahir. Postgraduate Diploma in Clinical Pharmacy with Merit, Sarah Joy Wilkinson. Johannes Sin Hao Yu. Postgraduate Diploma in Clinical Pharmacy, Wenxing Zhen. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record who have qualified for the conferment of a degree of the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences.
I call upon the Associate Dean of the Faculty of Science, Mrs. Goldstone, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Associate Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Science. Graduate Diploma in Science, Matthew Pierre Lucien Bonifoy. Shanshan Liu. David Thomas Rawson. Michael Sheffield. To the degree of Bachelor of Science, Rachel Irene Ahrens. Helen Elizabeth Abbey. Janice Abigail. Thomas Richard Abraham. Sophie Harriet Adair. Rebecca Amy Ade. Jack Norman Gray Adlam. Eleanor Dallas Reyes Adviento. Joseph Jeffrey Awong. Mohammed Ahmed Nawaz. Irvin Michael Alkanites. Thomas Simon Oldershoff. Mahalil Shemai El Alfonte. Sidra Ali. Samir Ali Akhatib. Cameron David Allen. Caitlin Nevitt Allen. Amanda. Salmia Ambati. Divya Kumati Amin. Vikesh Anand. Akshata Aaron Anchum. Tiffany Anastasia Anns. Shana Jean Anstis. Carl Anthony Pastor Antonio. Dana Brianna Applin, Laura Apriliani, Tasmaya and Ronnie, Andrew Patrick Ashkettle, Brian Lok Son Ao, Micah Daniel Rousing Austria, Bernadette Lagana Ayo, Ian David Babington, Paul Bike, Isaac Andrew Bain, Ina Bajaj, Jesse James Baker, Martin Lawrence Baker, Zara Baker, Annie Aloha Ball, Matilda Jane Ballinger, Hiroshini Balu, Joshua Louis Bannister, Leanne Barnfather, Charlotte Sarah Bartley, Angus Alexander Beatty, Mayan Joy Bedgood, Emma Jane Bell, Jack Henry Bell, Manjoth Kaur Benipal, Pooja Baramapa, Lewis Douglas Blake, Daniel Raymond James Bosson, Dwani Amit Bhutandra, Kyle Butcher, Chantel Renee Boyle, Stuart Anthony Bradley, Megan Jessie Dawn Brake, Dion Trent Bramley, Timothy Ian Brebner, Kate Hillary Brooks, Jessica Emily Mavis Brown, Yasmin Nicole Brown, Rebecca Nicole Bubb, Samaha Fadosh Buksh, Marina Almadine Marianne Burton, Stephanie Louisa Calvert, Justin Lloyd Cameron, Robert Ewan Cameron, Sarah Louise Kamel, Alistair David Carmichael, Macarena Paola Carrascosa, Lucy Bridget Carson, Danielle Louise Carter, Robert Douglas Cartwright, Sarah Ann Catley, Senior Scholar Science, Callum Mark Chalmers, Alex Ho Chun Chan, Christina Yuan Ying Chan, Esther Kai Yin Chan, Hao Man Godfrey Chan, Julian Hing Hin Chan, Prashika Chandra, Jasmine Tsi Chi Chen, Joseph Chi Chien Chin, Lan Chen, Ying Chung Chen, Zoe N Chen, Chiong Min Chi, Joey Chung, Melissa Yung Chung, Juliana Marietta Chulet, Alicia Ashley Shoka, Lundi Chun, Kimberly Fu Yin Chiang, Hayden Brett Chick, Wai Yi Winnie Chu, Jiwon Choi, Kevin Choi, James Yun Sin Chung, Ruth E. Chong, Andre Chow, Elliot George Christensen Yule, Yung Zhou Chung, Jeannie Chung, Susanna Margaret Clements, Hope Louise Collins Piggott, Abigail Mary Cockery, Ramona Marie Abadiah Cortis, Lauren Elizabeth Coop, Hamish Samuel Rutherford Craigie, Isabel Rose Crawford, Brady Marie Cress, Senior Scholar Science, Jennifer Elizabeth Crisp, Rose Lillian Crooks, Anna Catherine Cullum, Hao Shen Dai, Liang Dai, Hannah Mary Derrick, Lakshifa Yasasi Dasanayake, Gray Keith Davies, Nathaniel Aaron Davey, Jonathan Joseph Dawson, Natalie Elizabeth DeBerg, Ethigay Serini Stefani De Silva, Charlotte Louise de Villiers. Simon Johannan de Vries. Kai Ching Kieran Ding. Kerry Lee Detmer. Zachary Lawrence Devereaux. Samuel David Dillon. Stacey Claire Bridget Dillon. Ryan John Dixon. Agata Nathania Wirwati Jongjianto. Senior Scholar in Science, Sean Peter Dobson. Larissa Dong. Olivia Mary Donce. Nico Herman Dudemon. Imogen Ruby Dow. Senior Scholar in Science, Jackson Tobias Hawthorne Dowie. Victoria Draghi. Alan Joshua Dragovich. Dasha Diogo de Souza. Valerie Judith de Souza. Jade Tianawa Dudley. Sonali J. Dutt. Stephen Witterbrook Dyer. Lauren Peggy Eady. Cameron Eckblatt. Matthew James Allen. Dillon Michael Ellis. Kim Mary Esau. Thomas Jong Huat Yua. Jun Fung. Benjamin Norman Farrelly. Tanya Noel Gomez Furman. Tricia Nadine Gomez Furman. Senior Scholar Science, Elakoti Diraj Chandika Fernando. Olivia Fetu. Jesse Tana Fialeli. Daniel Evan Funston. Joan Finney. Thomas William Fisher. Kimberly Ellen Fitzmaurice. Sophia Morgan Fleming. Jia Yung Tracy Fu. Blaise John Forbes. Xavier Vincent Forsman. Nicola Louise Ford. Jamie Lee Foss. Robert Luke Franklin. Samuel Patrick Frew. Tessa Elizabeth Fura. Anne Bernadette Tamangalan. Amy Ruanka Gamagay. Nicholas Vienna Minovich Gimpel. Megan Elizabeth Ganley. Hu Ping Gao. Maya Alexandra Gary. Melissa Josephine Gate. Sern Gregor Skesi. Emma Jade Gilby. Kane Anthony Gillis. Natalie Jane Gilligan. Hugh Douglas Glossop. Katie Conway Glover. Soha Goma. Catherine May Ahenagondo. Lee Gong. Jana Ramiel Reyes Gonzalez. Guyana Shwar Sudan Gounda. Emerson Govan Sami. Kayla Ann Gray. Hanno Connor Greenfield. Ling Yu Guan. Ruchita Gupta. Sophia Tu Hin Ha. John Sidney Haggy. Jefferson Russell Haldane. Jonathan David Peter Hale. Carla Jane Hamilton. Jin Young Han. Ming Ying Han. Siung E Han. Morgan Emily Hancocks. Timothy Dylan Harker.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of the ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performance by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Mark Bingham on trombone, accompanied by Ya Ting Lu, will now perform the second movement by Ravel Sonatine.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mark and Yao Ting, for that wonderful performance. Please join me in thanking them once more. If you would like to hear more from our wonderful musicians, I invite you to attend the graduation gala concerto competition to be held in the Town Hall on Thursday, 12th of May at 7:30 p.m. Admission is free. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Science, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I call upon the Head of School of Psychology, Professor Hayward, to present further graduands in that faculty.
To the degree of Bachelor of Science, Jason Jeremy Hart. Matthew Gibson Halsra. Ashley Rose Haveman. Senior Scholar Science, Isabel Jane Hawkins. Joshua Tamati Niasha Hawkins. Kalia Janine Hawkins. Jody Rebecca Hayes. Julie Toipolotu He Mully. Yale Yuli Haled. Christopher Darius Herman. Janine Mary Hill. Aaron Jiwei Ho. Blake Paul Hodgkinson. Rebecca Ellen Hodgson. Lewis Samuel Hogan Estelle. Stuart Garth McLaughlin Holdaway. Joanna Margaret Holden. Michaela Sarah Holman. Jack Holmes. Kieran Jonathan Horrocks. Rami Shamshir Tag Hoshino. Ho Roy. Victoria Kai-Shuen Huang. Daniel John Hubbard. Christina Mary Humby. Chia Chun Hong. Emma Louise Hutchinson. Luke Daniel Thomas Ibs. Marina Gerges Torfik Hannah Ibrahim. Sophia Kalyan Ng. David Michael Jackson. Jatin Sharma Jamalamadaka. Justin Hanuri Jang. Lauren Anna Jeffers. Lurja Jiang. Swati Jivanji. Alexander James Johnston. Joshua Morgan Jones. Jillian Jew. Chewu Jun. Zana Michelle Jury. Pauline Canabar. Wei Hao Kang. Amandeep Kaur. Linda Jane Keegan. Andrew Joshua Keane. Guy Kennedy. Charles Colin Kenworthy. Zoe Elizabeth Agnes Key. Shinji Kihara. Chloe Chunmi Kim. Hyunji Kim. Hyunju Kim. Sungyeon Kim. Taiwan Kim. Youngjun Kim. Connor Albert Pilecki King. Raniera Teta Fiti Drew Kingi. Annalisa Michaela Kirk. Melissa Grace Kirk. Brittany Ray Knight. Josiah Samuel Knowles. Sunil Kong. Kwamin Koo. Kaj Kunchanarat. Ashish Kumar. Sawan Kumar. Sahil Shivam Kumar. Chelsea Ruby Lai. Ching Yin Lai. Sir Fung Leslie Lai. Akash Neil Lal. Chan Wai Lam. Jiang Hin James Lam. Mandy Cornelia Maria Ladenoy. Sihoi Doraline Lau. Chelsea Mae Lawrence. Melissa Annie Jo Lawrence. Ellen Mary Lawson. Maria Sarah Sukyun Lee. Jessica Rose Easdale LeGrace. Chun Yin Lee. Il Huan Lee. Jenny Rung Kong Lee. Jin Kelly Yanwei Lee. Rebecca Gayan Lee. Jianwen Lee. Claire Danielle Layton. Nikita Ashley Layton. Andy Kayu Leung. Demi Lee Julie Lavelle. To the degree of Bachelor of Science, Conjoint, Mohammed Faisal Amin Ansari and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. Senior Scholar Arts, Claire Elizabeth Black and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar Arts and Senior Scholar Science, Oliver Simon Brown and a Bachelor of Arts. Nicola Jane Calvin and a Bachelor of Arts. David Ka Yun Chan and a Bachelor of Music. Nandini Neelam Chand and a Bachelor of Commerce. Amara Eileen Clancy and a Bachelor of Arts. Nay Leila Dahl and a Bachelor of Arts. Ruben Edward Eady and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jesse Isla Gates and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. Jiwei Gong and a Bachelor of Commerce. Kasha Louise Grant and a Bachelor of Arts. Hayden Mark Green and a Bachelor of Commerce. Nicholas Jacob Higgins and a Bachelor of Commerce. William Ernest Ho and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jiong Soo Jun and a Bachelor of Commerce. Ji Yun Jiong and a Bachelor of Commerce. James Harry Kane and a Bachelor of Arts. Darren Robert Carl and a Bachelor of Arts. Ching Kuo and a Bachelor of Arts. Jeremy Jun Boon Lee and a Bachelor of Commerce. Senior Scholar Engineering, Kerry May Lintott, and a Bachelor of Engineering Honours with First Class Honours in Civil Engineering. Julia Marchwicker and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar Arts, Sylvia Martino, and a Bachelor of Arts. Amy Louise McMillan, and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar Business and Economics, Ryan Ross Mills, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Ravin Bharat Kumar Patel, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Bridie Catherine Carmine Popplewell and a Bachelor of Arts. Callum Davis Schmidt and a Bachelor of Commerce. Nicholas Alexander Shepherd and a Bachelor of Commerce. Krasni Srivastava and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jason Peter Swanevelder and a Bachelor of Arts. Justin Keith Tirado Takeda and a Bachelor of Commerce. Senior Scholar Arts and Senior Scholar Science, Charles Timo Turbis and a Bachelor of Arts. Jacob Theo Vanderpoel and a Bachelor of Commerce. Natalie Jean Van Rossen and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sukanya Nishith Vyas and a Bachelor of Arts. Gabriel Lun Yu Wong and a Bachelor of Commerce. Lawrence Lok Hong Wong and a Bachelor of Music. Yin Chin Yin and a Bachelor of Arts. Chancellor, I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Science, Professor Hosking, to present further graduands.
postgraduate diploma in Bioscience Enterprise with distinction. Dominique Grace Newby. Samuel Christopher Wojcik. Postgraduate diploma in Bioscience Enterprise with merit, Nikita Kapoor. Lee Thomas Kersop. Postgraduate diploma in science with distinction, Quentin Heath Burrell in biomedical science. Alex Koischer in biomedical science. Samantha Terry Denton in psychology. Aisha Omprakash Karadi in statistics. Sarah Ann Killick in biosecurity and conservation. Postgraduate diploma in science with merit. Pisani Kavisha Bodiyabarao in biomedical science. Devishish Chand in biomedical science. Shannon Arnold Chand in pharmacology. Timothy Daniel Christopher in chemistry. Melissa Jane Coots in psychology. Dongsu Lee in earth sciences. Anna Natalie Lewis in marine science. Postgraduate diploma in science, Su Yuan Chan in mathematics. Cara Raquel Marta Harrison Crichton in marine science. Elisa Venus Valeroso Fernandez in pharmacology. Johnny Gaglioni Scolaro in environmental management. Fuying Hu in wine science. Song Huang in computer science. Jianho Zhang in wine science. Chia Harindrakuma Kansara in pharmacology. Harrison Taiyun Kim in statistics. Yuntian Lee in food science. Qixiang Lin in chemistry. To the degree of Master of Bioscience Enterprise with Second Class Honours, First Division. Simon Francis Mackay Gordon and a Postgraduate Diploma in Bioscience Enterprise with distinction. To the degree of Master of Science with First Class Honours, Muhammad Hassan E. Abuwawa in biomedical science. Nicholas Chad Andrews in biological sciences. University graduate scholar Jennifer Bramwell in statistics and a Bachelor of Science honours with first class honours in mathematics and a Bachelor of Commerce and a Bachelor of Science conjoint. Valerie Tracy Chang in psychology. Danielle Patricia Courtney in psychology. Erin Catherine Celine Crosby in biological sciences. Thomas Andrew Drain in statistics. Josiah Zan Insing in Geophysics. Jonathan Harold Goodman in Statistics. Maria Hermans in Biological Sciences. Leroy Armstrong Hudson in Chemistry and a postgraduate diploma in Forensic Science with merit. Toby Shang-Yan Hung in Computer Science and a postgraduate diploma in Science and Computer Science. Elizabeth Kate Judd in Psychology. Pamela Lauren Kane in Marine Science. Hyun Kyung Kim in Sport and Exercise Science. Isabel Tina Lam in Geography. Rebecca Jane Legris in Biological Sciences. Stephen Lowe in Chemistry. University graduate scholar Scott Daniel McGowan in Geology. June Pauline Barit Misa in Biomedical Science. Ilya Alexievich Litvinenko in Computer Science. Mrinal Murali in Biomedical Science and a Bachelor of Science and a Postgraduate Diploma in Science and Biomedical Science. Junkyo Oh in Biological Sciences and a Bachelor of Technology with Second Class Honours, First Division. Ben Leif Rushton in Biological Sciences and a Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Merit in Biological Sciences. Chung Yi Sim in Geophysics and a Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Merit in Geophysics. University Graduate Scholar Marisa Sorchi in Biosecurity and Conservation. Rachel Louise Sumner in Psychology. Zakaya Vadati in Biomedical Science and a Postgraduate Diploma in Science in Biomedical Science. Lucinda Kate Osterholm in Marine Science. Stephen Lachlan Wallace in Biosecurity and Conservation. Chua Wong in Computer Science. Simon Carlson Wagner in Environmental Management. Rachel Marie Tulia West in Biomedical Science. Christopher James Wilkinson in Statistics and a Bachelor of Science Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division in Statistics and a Bachelor of Science. Ian Shane Wong in Statistics and a Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Merit in Statistics. Bonnie Yu in Applied Mathematics. To the degree of Master of Science with Second Class Honours, First Division. Silla Camilla Sharona Brown in Environmental Management.
Alia Desai in Clinical Exercise Physiology. Anne Hong in Food Science. Inderjeet Kaur in Wine Science. Thomas William Meader in Clinical Exercise Physiology. Noor Liana Nuxman in Biological Sciences. Craig Allen Parker in Clinical Exercise Physiology. Lilith Lee Pung in Statistics. Shireen Radhika Sharma in Forensic Science. Hulita Filoaki Ofahilotu Tauvili in Psychology. Rhiannon Elizabeth Webb in Psychology. Devlin J. White in Forensic Science. To the degree of Master of Science with Second Class Honours, Second Division. Sophie Fay Burgess in Marine Science. Bronwyn Ruth Cann in Biological Sciences. Anne-Marie Jean Gibson in Wine Science. Andrew Ray Gordon in Geology. Melissa Ann Harrison in Geography. Sebastian Richard Phillips James in Clinical Exercise Physiology and a postgraduate diploma in science with merit in Clinical Exercise Physiology. Chow Lee in Computer Science. Michael John McElvride in Clinical Exercise Physiology. Jessica Amy Price in Forensic Science. Ian Robert Simon Simpringham in Clinical Exercise Physiology. Wang Shu Yu in Psychology. To the degree of Master of Science, Haneen Tariq Khan in Biological Sciences. Chun To Lee in Biological Sciences. Velalath Madam Vinod Ramakrishnan in Clinical Exercise Physiology. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record who have qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Science.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Clinical Psychology, Elizabeth Seasanga Marty. From the perspective of Māori and Pacific youth offenders and program staff at the Genesis Youth Project in South Auckland, Elizabeth explored factors associated with positive behavioural change. The establishment of a positive therapeutic relationship was deemed a necessary component and an effective intervention aimed at reducing reoffending. Elizabeth, congratulations. Sarah Marie Myers, University Doctoral Scholar. Sarah conducted a postal survey of 5,000 randomly selected individuals from the New Zealand electoral roll to ascertain attitudes toward youth offenders and responses to their offending, including rehabilitation, punishment, community protection, and restorative justice. She also assessed public support for community-based interventions and whether the public believed there is an age at which it is too late to help a youth offender. Sarah. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Alistair Avery Abbott in Computer Science, University Doctoral Scholar. In his thesis, which was undertaken jointly with the École Normale Supérieure in Paris, Alistair worked on results improving our understanding of the nature and origin of randomness in measurements of quantum systems. He used mathematical tools from theoretical computer science to better understand the quality of quantum randomness and looked at how this randomness can be used to generate random numbers that are certified by physical principles. Alistair. Safura Binti Abdul Jalil in Computer Science. Safura investigated the effectiveness of a modular game-based learning approach in helping computer science students learn about visual aesthetics. Her work included the design, development, and evaluation of a bespoke game-based learning prototype for this specific educational context. Her research contributes to human-computer interaction education and provides valuable insights for other research efforts in the game-based approach to learning design-related subjects. Safura. Siti Khadija Abdul Karim in Biological Sciences. Siti generated royal gala cell cultures which were subsequently induced to differentiate through manipulation of plant hormones. She also studied fruit size control among three apple cultivars at molecular and cellular levels by investigating the role of cell division and cell expansion in apple growth to determine which of these processes contributes to final fruit size.
Congratulations.
Muhammad Abdul Latif in Computer Science, University Doctoral Scholar. Citation classification can enable better assessment of the impact of a researcher's publications. Previous citation classification required predefined citation schemes and a manually annotated training dataset. Muhammad proposed a new citation classification technique that is able to classify citations without a predefined scheme or human intervention. Experimentation demonstrated good performance across multiple research areas. Muhammad. Peter William Akers in Chemistry. Using a mixture of chemical and microbiological techniques, Peter investigated the structure and activity of biomolecules at the solid-liquid interface, testing the effects that different modes of binding have on surface activity. He found that while biomolecules are readily bound, the mode of binding and the chemical environment is critical to activity at the surface. Joshua Ubo Benjamin in Psychology, University Doctoral Scholar. Joshua investigated both traditional and modern theories of learning via positive reinforcement using a combination of mathematical models, experimental data, and computer simulations. His results suggest that organisms use positive reinforcers, such as food, as sources of information about how to obtain further positive reinforcers. Emily Margaret Boyd in Chemistry. Emily developed new chemical reactions to enable the first synthesis of two natural products that are available only in tiny amounts from their natural source. Her research ultimately produced a quantity of these natural products upon which a comprehensive biological evaluation of their medicinal properties could be performed. Emily. Alan Kwok Lun Cheong in geography. Alan developed a computational method to monitor and explain the behaviour of landscape systems through time and space. Using this method, Alan examined the evolving landscapes of the Qinghai Tibetan Plateau in China. Results from this study will allow scientists and other stakeholders to create better plans for environmental protection. Gayan Haruka de Zoiza in chemistry. Using advanced chemical and microbiological techniques, Gayan developed novel antibacterial lipopeptides and established their therapeutic potential as antibiotics of the future. Gayan's original contribution to the field of medicinal chemistry has practical implications in solving the global public health issue of antimicrobial resistance that threatens the achievements of modern medicine. Johannes Alwi Webosono Dimyadi in computer science. Johannes looked at how building regulations can be represented effectively for computer processing to support compliant building design and automated compliance audit processes. One practical impact of his research is to improve the slow and costly building consenting process, which he demonstrated using a case study of performance-based fire safety design of buildings in the New Zealand regulatory environment. Johannes, congratulations. James Peter Diprose in Computer Science, University Doctoral Scholar. James explored how to reduce the effort required to program socially interactive robots. He contributed a means to carefully balance the comprehensive control required for realistic human-robot interaction with the ability to simplify the way that social robots are programmed. His work will lead to more successful programming of socially aware robots that are used as companions, teachers, and caregivers. James, congratulations. Svetlana Valerievna Fagan in psychology, University Doctoral Scholar. Svetlana investigated the previously unexplored field of people who commit criminal offences for altruistic reasons from both the public and personal perspectives. Her findings suggest a need for legal considerations of altruistic offenders with regards to rehabilitation and sentencing, and also the plausibility of true altruistic behaviour motivated by a compassionate response to the suffering of others. Christina Grace Fullerton in Food Science. Christina looked at how variation in the cell walls of kiwi fruit genotypes result in different softening rates. This research can be applied to identify chemical and genetic markers for kiwi fruit breeding, enabling early selection of new types of fruit with desired softening rates. This would give the New Zealand kiwi fruit industry a competitive edge in the global kiwi fruit market. Christina, congratulations. Brendan Darrell Harvey in chemistry, bright future top achiever doctoral scholar. Brendan studied the development of new catalysts that would enable important chemical reactions to be carried out with more selectivity and efficiency. He synthesised an entirely new cyclic ligand system and use this to make metal catalysts for the transformation of carbon monoxide and acetylene into higher value organic products. David Sir-Rung Hwang in computer science. David looked at finding and analysing interesting data patterns in big data. He focused particularly on discovering changes in data streams and further investigated their implications. His work has wide applicability in large-scale data, such as the analysis of tweets and Google keyword queries. David's work results in our better understanding of and decision-making in practical applications of analysis and forecasting. Paul Alexander Hume in chemistry, university doctoral scholar. Paul designed and carried out the first chemical synthesis of the naturally occurring molecule vergatolide B. This compound was discovered during a screening program searching for potential anti-cancer agents. Paul's strategy used interactions present within the molecule itself in order to direct formation of synthetic material identical to the naturally occurring substance. Paul, congratulations. Nabila Binti Ismail in chemistry. The availability of clean water is becoming a rapidly growing global problem. Nabila developed a new class of smart catalytic films that purify water effectively and inexpensively. Organic pollutants such as pesticides, herbicides, and endocrine disruptors are catalytically oxidized to harmless material as the water simply runs over the films. These discoveries have been protected by two patents. Abila, congratulations. Jae-kyung Jung in physics, university doctoral scholar. Jae-kyung experimentally investigated previously unexplored fundamental dynamics and potential applications of temporal cavity solitons, which are pulses of light circulating in a loop of fibre. His study could pave the way for implementation of all optical reconfigurable buffers, a key element in future optical telecommunication systems. Jake, congratulations. Soo-hee Jong in pharmacy. Soo-hee developed a novel assay for cytosine, a smoking cessation medication, and measured cytosine levels for the first time in humans. Using these data, she was able to investigate the relationship between cytosine levels in blood and the effects on psychological measures such as craving, nicotine withdrawal, smoking satisfaction, and mood in smokers. This has the potential to impact on smoking cessation therapy worldwide. Soo-hee, congratulations. Leonie Sharon Josephine Susan Jones in chemistry. Leonie conducted a comprehensive experimental and theoretical investigation of the factors affecting the non-covalent interactions between porphyrins and fullerenes as one-to-one complexes in the solid state. Her research has implications in the fields of computational chemistry, supramolecular chemistry, crystal engineering, and in the design of molecular devices for solar energy conversion. Leonie, congratulations. Harveen Kaur in biological sciences. Harveen developed a novel synthetic strategy to prepare a range of bioactive cyclic peptides with antifungal, bone growth promoting, and antithrombotic properties. She also synthesized a valuable antiplatelet agent for a contest which offered a $100,000 reward for 1 milligram. Congratulations. Mm-hmm. Lian Xian Ko in chemistry. Lian investigated the photophysics and photochemistry of novel light-harvesting molecules using laser spectroscopy. She evaluated the effectiveness of these molecules as energy carriers and thus their potential as active materials in solar cells. Lian, congratulations. Amit Arvind Kokja in geography. Amit tackled the problems commonly associated with urban land cover classification through fusing multi-sensory data. A standardised multi-stage segmentation classification workflow based on existing data fusion methods using satellite data was developed to identify the land covers that are normally found in core urban areas. Amit, well done. Arben Kuruvilla Matthew in speech science. Arben used human electroencephalography and behavioural methods to understand the effects of hearing loss on the brain. This research aimed at improving the diagnosis and treatment of hearing impairment by determining how the brain processes acoustic cues that are important for successful speech perception in the back and the presence of background noise. Arben, well done. Xinqing Li in statistics. The generalised hyperbolic distribution and its limit cases have been recognised by researchers for their non-Gaussian properties, which make them useful in almost all areas of finance and risk management. Xinqing identified problems arising in the use of generalised hyperbolic distribution in statistical applications due to the complexity of the distribution and investigated both theoretical and computational solutions. Congratulations. Katerina Limbach in psychology, university doctoral scholar. Katerina investigated why and how our performance in simple perceptual tasks, such as detecting a brief visual stimulus, varies from moment to moment. She related this behavioural variability to fluctuations in ongoing brain activity, and thus gained insight into how we perceive and interact with the world around us. Katerina, congratulations. Ni Lu in computer science. Ni developed a new method for texture recognition by extending the conventional LBP-LTP-based classifier towards learning the most characteristic shape, sizes, and number of patterns. The proposed method showed improved results in texture classification and in medical image segmentation of the kidney. Ni, congratulations. Jennifer Ann Long in psychology, university doctoral scholar. Jenny looked at waste and transport behaviours in a friendship-based school social network. She examined constructions of environmental action, whether friends were similar in their self-reported behaviour, and whether similarities arose from social influence. Congratulations, Jen. Hongtao Su in pharmacy, university doctoral scholar. Hongtao's study focused on development of a strategy to overcome drug resistance in pancreatic cancer. He developed multifunctional nanoparticles which could deliver an anti-cancer drug along with a drug resistance reversal agent specifically to the tumour. How the smart delivery system works within the cancer cells and its pharmacokinetics in animals were also investigated. Congratulations, Hong Kong. Xudong Yao in pharmacy, university doctoral scholar. Eddie's doctoral studies aimed to provide proof of concept into the possible role of lactoferrin as a new oral treatment for osteoporosis. He developed polymer-coated lipid particles to deliver lactoferrin, which improved therapeutic efficacy and minimised adverse side effects. This, combined with its simplicity, nature and convenience, will sequentially improve patient compliance and treatment outcomes. Congratulations. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a doctoral degree in the Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences and the Faculty of Science.
We are now nearing the end of this graduation ceremony. On behalf of the university, I invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. And while you are standing, it will be a good opportunity for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieve their qualifications. Thank you. This concludes this meeting of council and convocation of the university for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your programme.